I have to be honest, you know, being someone whose main tool in my toolbox is my prescribing power, I didn't realize that, hey, you know what, medicines aren't the first line treatment. We really should be using these other modalities. But when we do need to use pharmacology, let's try to be reasonable and evidence-based. So, as we've said, pharmacologic treatments are not considered first-line treatments. Very important to understand. Most FDA-approved insomnia drugs are meant for short-term use, and yet in the real world, Jade, I think they get used chronically a lot. The advantage is, of course, they're very accessible. They work pretty rapidly. They're effective in some ways. But there's risks, of course. There ain't no free. The side effects, as we know, significant side effects in some cases. Some of them have the risk of physiologic and psychological dependence and are maybe controlled substances, building up of tolerance, or so-called tachyphylaxis. And then especially for older adults, we're really concerned about cognition and things like falls and balance problems, right? And then, as we heard from Jade, of course, pills don't teach skills. Right, Jay?
That's correct.
Pills don't teach skills, so they're not addressing these other issues here, the behavioral, the psychological, social mechanisms, if you will. But if we have to talk about medication, let's at least start from understanding what are the FDA-approved treatments. And those of you who've been coming to NEI for a while probably a little tired of hearing me say this, but we should always start with an FDA-approved or at least evidence-based treatment. So here we have the benzodiazepine hypnotics. Not all benzodiazepines are FDA approved for insomnia, but many of them are, as you see here. The so-called non-benzodiazepine Z drugs, we like to call them, because you can see they all have Zs in there. As far as antidepressants, not everybody may realize this, but there is a low-dose formulation of doxepin, an older tricyclic antidepressant that is actually FDA approved for insomnia. We, of course, have the newer orexin antagonists, and there are now three. The newest one is daridorexant. And then we have one melatonin receptor agonist. Now, interestingly, there are a couple of melatonin receptor agonists on the market. One of them, tasimelteon, is approved for non-24, but not for insomnia specifically, sort of a funny quirk. Then, of course, we use over-the-counter melatonin, but it's not FDA approved. Antipsychotics, okay. Over 70% of you got this right. But Jade and I are greedy. We want 100%. Notice, quetiapine is not FDA approved. Was that loud enough?
Maybe a little louder.
A little louder, okay.
In the back.
Quetiapine! And those of you at home, are you listening? Quetiapine is not FDA approved.
Nope.
Neither is olanzapine. And then anticonvulsants, which interestingly, I have to be honest, I have sometimes prescribed, especially gabapentin, at times, especially if someone has pain or some other associated symptoms. But here you see, these are the ones that are commonly used. Many of these are evidence-based, and many of them are FDA approved.